Flutter by, butterfly, into the sky, into the sky, till you're out of sight. And I won't run, I won't fight. Oh, oh, I've got my feet on the ground. I will be there with my hands held high, and I will reach to the sky. Oh.
Yeah. I think this is the first actual butterfly garden that I've seen that's an actual butterfly garden, not just dead plants. Almost every garden we ever go to is dead. The flowers aren't alive. Oh wow, they really like those flowers. Maybe I need to get some of them. They really like those flowers. Oh, there's a bunch of weird. To get some of these flowers to go in my walking garden down there. That would be nice to have all of them down in my garden. What do you think, girls? I think it would be nice. I can't believe how much these butterflies, I mean these little butterflies love these flowers. Definitely would be worth it. I don't see a sign. Let's see. Let's see, these ones say wild something others. Let's see. Is there a sign? Come on, bird. Turf fries. No. No, no. Well, I guess we might not get to know, guys. There's another one over here. Let's see. Rigid gold, golden rods. That might be what they are. No. I think these are different. So those don't got no name. Well, if any of you that watch my video and you know what these flowers are, let me know. Because there is pretty cool. I know those are button ones. I looked. I've only seen two, and I didn't see one for the other one. Yeah, I was looking. I didn't see. There was like a white, but you see how this is set up? Okay, well, my garden. Because this is exactly what I want to do.
Four bees right there. A bunch.
Oh, my.
But there's bees.
Look at those. Holy moly.
Got your wings high.
Yes. That's crazy. Wonder why they like those.
And there's big butterflies like these ones. And bumblebees. Bumblebees and
regular bees. Wow.
And blue butterflies. Yellow butterflies.
This little garden area, guys, is kind of what I want to do in my lower garden down there. The idea of it.
There's tags here, but I don't know if they're for it. I mean, they're not no right.
Bunch of bumblebees on this one.
If you get a good picture or video of them, I can find the flower. Looks like they're on these real good, too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're sweat bees.
That is not sweat bees. This is honeybees.
These are mainly down here.
Oh, I don't know, but this right here is honeybees.
Yeah, I know those. And there's another honeybees.
Okay, good.
Well, I haven't walked around, so you all can keep on walking.
This is the back side. There ain't really nothing back there.
That butterfly is beautiful.
We just walked back here to stand in the shade.
That butterfly is beautiful, too.
Oh, he's looking. I can't believe these weird bees on this one.
I know. I wonder what they're getting that they are so obsessed with.
They're the same thing. After nectar.
They get mad.
They were doing that while I go to on the other side.
Run away!
Unless you want to video the spot where the deers eat their plants. Those that are they're sticking up over there. See the little shoots that are sticking up? They eat the whole back side off back there. I don't know if they look like sweet peas or something.
But that's kind of my idea for what I want to do down there. Alright. Come on, kids.
Well, we can eat it.
Let's see if there's any bats. We must look. Oak shelter. Old bat shelter. Let's see. Zoom, zoom.
I see more than this. Oh, God, that thing is flying low.
Remember the plane on the Expendables? The big silver, crazy looking plane on the Expendables?
Yeah.
Kind of what that was. An old military air cargo plane. Smoking like hell.
I kind of
like that. I don't think we need to build one quite as big, but that's pretty cool. We could build a little bat box.
There's a lot of wasp nests.
Bats cut down on bugs.
And there is some hay in there.
It'd be hard to see them. There's been something else big that's went up in there because it's chewed the two before over here. I could see that possums and other stuff. See, there's been something right up here in the corner. Yeah. You would get squirrels, and that's the problem with their design.
So they're clearing out the tree line and over that way?
No, they're working on utilities. They're probably clearing out the trees off the fire line and stuff on poles. Here's another one of the trail.
What does it say?
This is the purple field trail. It goes around this field.
Oh. Goes around all the grass. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, their trails basically go around certain areas. Different biomes.
What?
Bad buggy.
Wow. Look, it's another June bug. In July. It's funny how they stick out when they're right there and you get close to them, they'll stick their hind legs out. They got their little talons on there. Because they're evil.
Did y'all hear that wild bumblebee?
It's a pretty wild bumblebee. Only in nature. Aha. We're funny. Barbara.
Wild berries. Don't eat wild berries.
Don't eat the wild berries.
Don't eat the wild berries. I love the dragon claw. Hard to see. You're walking in front of it. And almost stepped on it till it flew away. It's the second time she almost stepped on something. She almost stepped on a butterfly.
Ooh. Some little stairs. It's a blue trail.
Boop, boop, boop.
Oh, we're going to go down this one.
Okay. Periodic. I love the nature, guys. I like hiking.
Cut down the field trail. I didn't notice that we could have went down the field trail. We have to pop out on the field and back into the field.
Looks like something's been digging right there. This is so pretty. Just all kinds of stuff around here. That's another spot. It's the sun coming through. They're all about going really fast, and I'm taking my time back here. I'm looking around. Me and the YouTube fam is looking around while you're all racing to the finish line. So it ended up circling back out what he was saying earlier. circled right back out to the field that we went past. So it was a big loop. Came back out to the field. It goes back in down here. Look at that. All that's grown up like crazy. Butterfly up there. That was the number one rule, is do not touch stuff, especially the grass, because around here, poison ivy is in abundance. See, poison ivy and poison oak is real bad. Pawpaw tree. That's another pawpaw tree. I think. Pretty sure those are pawpaws. Yeah, they're pawpaws. There was some pawpaws on them. I'm walking and looking. There's the trails, more blue. I can't remember how many it was from the beginning to now. It's all different paths and different colors. There was one that was, what was it? Purple? I think purple was supposed to be the one that was really long, if I remember right. Sorry if this ends up a little shaky. Forgot to bring. Every time we come out, I forget to bring my mount to hold and stabilize everything. So there's another plane. Where is it at? Is that why there's so many? Oh.
Also used as a storage location to keep perishable foods cool.
See where they walk? Right down there.
Spring.
Not much of a spring left, is it?
So you've got a box over here. That's probably where they stored their perishables.
Go down here. Zoom.
A spring box. You build a box out of rocks. And sticky milk.
There we go.
Yeah, that one's falling a little bit better than the upper one.
Yeah, that one's got more coming out, see it?
Yeah, that's what that would have been. That would have been their storage. There would have been a little roof over that. You can see where those little nails are sticking up out of the rock on both sides?
Yep.
So they would have walked down here from that house up in here. All the way down here to give.
And that's the house that I showed you guys from the beginning, the white one.
and your water will make all the stuff there. Cool.
And back that down there.
Why didn't y'all run into that spiderweb when you were there?
Because we are short.
Here I walked through there and I did too. How did we miss it the first time?
I don't know. Got
the scar across the forehead that time.
But basically, this is the only place we could find down here that.
That was close enough for us to get back.
Yeah, close enough for us to get back for her appointment that we're going to. But we also figured out, you know, there is no parking down here whatsoever. We looked everywhere for parking, and literally.
That's why there's fencing on these trees, because they don't want the beaver to eat them. Beaver done eat them too.
Yeah. So they got fencing there and there.
What's funny though is the beaver must have died or something because he didn't take his tree with him.
Look what they can do.
Better one. There's a better one.
That's an old one, and look, the tree has attempted to repair itself.
I can see water over there.
Where we were walking to. Why is the blue trail?
The blue trail of the water trail.
Wow. It's kind of funny though, they only got the wire on those. They didn't put it on any of the other trees. None of these other ones have it. Must have just been getting that one spot. Get all the light coming through. Isn't it pretty?
Right here, there used to be a fence. Right here. There's a little fence post. Not much of a fence post left. They had it fenced off out here.
So boy, that tree's about to go down too.
That must have been the original car property because this was a fence line.
Yeah.
This was probably something sacred, or they just had it fenced off there.
Been
a little kid with about a 5-inch foot stomping all in the mud.
Ew. Not I, says me.
Who's that? They like water. Dragonflies.
Well, that's what we walked down here for. Now we gotta turn around and back up. Well, we could circle back around through the field trail, but it'd be hot walking back up through the field. It'd be better to walk back up to that split and then go around the red trail.
Big tadpole. He almost big enough to have legs.
The ones over here, the ones over there.
Over there.
No, the ones over here is the ones I was.
Oh. There's more.
Multiple turtles.
Right there. Oh, I was on the ones on the tree. We all were talking about different ones. The one in the middle right there.
Oh, there's turtles over there.
Yeah, there's turtles over there. There's turtles over here.
I was looking at the turtles over here. Like turtles. I like turtles.
The red trail comes down in the back of that, way back in there.
Oh, there's a dragonfly. Wait, wait, wait. He ran away.
Those weird bugs. What are those bugs?
You see, it's
a
little red fly right here, dude.
Those bugs.
Probably.
What are those?
Those?
It's a dragonfly.
They're dragonflies of a type.
They don't look like dragonflies. They have a weird face.
We are to Red Trail now.
Kinda.
Blue was way down yonder.
The red kind of splits both ways. This takes the traffic toward the face.
Yeah.
Instead of going back around the way we came down.
Blue way down there. See if I can catch that spider. Nope. Where'd
we'll
it go?
Put it on there. Is that way? Yeah.
He's dangling right there.
And you have a picture of the entire map. This red trail goes back down there to the tip of the reservoir where it comes back.
Oh, it goes around.
Well, then it goes, I think it goes all the way around. Red goes down there to the tip of the water, and then it goes up and around on top of the ridge and back around. This is kind of just a little triangle spar of red.
Oh. You think? Sure. We're not on the wrong red path.
Goes out here and connects with Whitetail and then comes back that way. So we should run into another.
There are little hidden little suckers everywhere. If you're not being safe, trip over them. Back up again.
Thank you.
I'm a butterfly in your hand. That's where I chose to land. I lost my mind, but who cares? I don't mind, I'm not scared. They're staring.
Ivy Creek National Area. Gotta keep up with everybody or they'll leave me behind. Big old place. Big old barn. Boy, is it hot. See that? Oh my. Burning up. Whew. It's hot. Okay, time for a water break.
You want to use in the bathroom or coming home?
Here you go. There's little frogs everywhere. TJ about stomped him. There's Mr. Squirrel. Everywhere I go, I find these squirrels. He's trying to crack a nut.
See where it's all black around his mouth? Because of his walnut.
And then there's family.
They don't get them while they're green. They wait till they turn black down here on the ground and take them back up the tree and crack them open. So his mouth's all black.
Looks like somebody has shot them.
You got it open.
I thought she did something with the deal.
I got half of a chicken sandwich, Chick-fil-A, waiting on Xavier's burger, girls. Okay.
There's you something to give a bad review.
What'd they do now?
They cannot heat up your bun. It's pre-packaged, they don't have a fucking microwave, and they're afraid they'll contaminate.
Did you tell them that I'm not celiac?
Said it didn't have no way to heat it up. Legal liability reasons, it says gluten-free, they can't heat it up. What's safe? They don't have a microwave. Which is bullshit, I can see a microwave from the counter.
Really?
Yep, so you get a
So did bun. You not talk to the other
I
one?
I talked to the manager just then.
Did you tell her?
Wouldn't do it. Would not do it. She wouldn't take that burger back at all.
Okay.
It's cold. It's going to be cold. They get straight out of the refrigerator.
Lovely Chick-fil-A experience.
Chick-fil-A offers the gluten-free bun.
They offer the gluten-free bun, but it is cold. I mean, like, it's like straight up out of the refrigerator. Cold. Bun. Straight cold. They serve it separately. They got a microwave in there. Let me see.
I don't know if you can see it around here. I could see it back through here. It looks like a microwave. They got a grill.
If I could see it.
But they won't put it on the grill because they're afraid they'll contaminate it. I said, I know it was just gluten intolerant, but not celiac. Contamination wouldn't really matter. Apologize and refuse.
Life of somebody that is gluten free. We'll see if this cold bun.
You might as well ask for no moon.
And they didn't even give me cheese. Didn't it have cheese?
No, it
had cheese on in the picture.
I don't think so. I think it just had less than tomato. Yeah, it's just less than tomato. Pickles. They put pickles on their chicken biscuit. I'm getting ready to put some ranch on my sandwich.
What?
I bet that bun tasted like butt.
That is so disgusting.
It's quino. I told you. I guarantee it tasted like butt.
Oh. That is so disgusting.
Quino and molasses.
It's cold.
And molasses.
And it's cold. And that's nasty. And they won't heat it up. Don't get it.
Just order it with no bun.
Don't get it. Chick-fil-A.
Tried but failed.
Nasty. Nasty nastiness. Wasted money. Ugh. So bad.
Wrap it up in lettuce.
You didn't even eat your lesson, mate.
Might as well have just ordered this, because they had this chopped up and called it grilled nuggets.
Just realized that we forgot to tell you guys what happened with Chick-fil-A on the way home. So, we got our orders, got out there, had all of it set up, and Xavier didn't get his food. So, we got there at like, what was it, 9:30 or so?
Like
by the time they got done getting their order, and we told them that we were dining in, but when we got our order, it was still on in a bag, and then he had to go back, so that took even longer. Then he got back out there, and we sat down, and we were eating. I done the little bit of recording for you guys on the gluten-free bun, and the, like, immediately after that, this lady comes out there and looks at us and tells us that we need to leave, basically. She's like, I'm just letting you know that we're closing and all the customers need to be off the premises inside and outside by 10:15. It wasn't even 10 o'clock yet. And she was already running customers out of the inside. They'd done locked down the inside. And then she was telling us to leave. So we basically looked at her and told her we'll leave when we get done eating. And she's like, well, I'm just telling you. I was like, well, you know, when we get done eating. Usually I'm not like that. But, you know, they refuse to warm up the bun, which was dreadfully cold. I mean, like, it was solid cold. And yeah, and they were advertising this bun as supposed to be just like this amazing thing that is supposed to be, you know, the new thing with Chick-fil-A. I think they're putting it they said it was supposed to be worldwide. I believe the lighting's in here bad.
Well, I mean, it's company-wide. I mean, wherever Chick-fil-A is,
yeah.
All of them supposed to have.
All of them supposed to have this nasty bun. They will. Yeah, it. They cut.
It's separate. I've seen it done before at other places, but they've always put the buns, you know, over something hot so that it steams, so that it warms it up. And basically, they are not doing that, but they are also
take it out of the plastic package and put it on the sandwich.
Yeah, they didn't touch it. But they didn't do anything, and they refused to get it out. The manager said that, they didn't have a microwave, and that it was a liability for them to take it out. Even though I stated that I was not celiac, I was eating the French fries that was in there. I was just gluten-free. And she still refused to warm it up. So, no matter what, I was getting a cold, cold bun. Then they made us wait another, I don't know how long, for Xavier's food. And then they tried to run us off right after we got there. So, it was just the worst experience. Horrible food. And, you know, I basically, the only thing I eat was the grilled chicken. I could have got that in the grilled chicken nuggets, as they call them. And
stray cat walking in the parking lot wouldn't even eat the bun. That's how terrible it was.
It was so bad, and it is just
texture-wise, though, it was soft and nice, like an actual real bun.
Yeah, it was just cold.
But cold and nasty.
And gritty. Very gritty. So
Quino or Quino or whatever, however that's pronounced, should never be used in anything.
No.
That stuff is terrible.
So, just a warning for any of you that is gluten-free, don't go to Chick-fil-A. Don't get the gluten-free bun. It is not worth the money. It is cold. They will not warm it up for you. And it's just not worth it. It's not worth paying for that at all. It's disgusting. It's so bad. And I'm not exaggerating on that. It was just bad. But, you know, with the service that we got from Chick-fil-A, I was very disappointed in A, their advertisement for their gluten-free bread, and B, the entire staff at Chick-fil-A. And we won't be going back.
I think we could have got a bigger, better chicken sandwich for less money across the road at McDonald's.
Yeah, yeah.
I know we could have. The chicken sandwiches are bigger at McDonald's.
Yeah.
And definitely cheaper.
So, I just wanted to follow you up on that. And we are home. We're all going to bed. It's been a long day. And I thought I'd just tell you how that Chick-fil-A turned out. Was not good. So, save your money. Don't go get it. And if anybody from Chick-fil-A is watching this, make sure that if it's late and you're all closing soon, to be sure to tell your customers that you are closing and that there is a rule or an obligation for you guys to close. Don't go run people out. I watched this Chick-fil-A run three couples who got dine-in, went and sat down. They ran them out. They ran the people off in the parking lot, and they come out there and demanded us to leave after we got dine-in and was sitting outside. It's just rude, and it also makes the company look bad. And yeah, you guys definitely need to work on that.